Daisy, can you believe Koaw let us do this again?
Nope, I'm truly bewildered.
I was just napping, and Koaw came by to tell me that some subscribers requested we do this again. Koaw then went off searching for cicadas to eat. Seriously, that dude is weird. Okay, Daisy, what animals are we doing this week?
Reptiles.
Reptiles? Like snakes, lizards, and turtles?
Yes.
Alrighty then. Let's go over 5 reptiles found in our neck of the woods. Hello, human people. I am Chubs. Yes, the gorgeous groundhog you see right there. And that is Daisy. She'll be tossing up Koaw's footage as we move along.
Hello, human people.
Okay, Daisy, toss up the first reptile. Turtles. I love these things. They're like the laziest creatures I've ever met. It makes me so proud to see them just lounging in the water and on top of logs all day long. They are truly the kings and queens of taking naps. So these are red-eared sliders, which are usually pretty easy to identify because they're the only turtle around here with a red line coming from the eye. The females will have the brightest red spot, and the red will be less apparent on males. And some old males just won't show any red and just kind of have a black head.
Eastern painted turtles have red on the head.
Oh yeah, Daisy has a good point. The eastern painted turtles around here do have red on the head also, but it's not coming from the back of the eye, it starts more in the neck. So I mean, the hardest part of a red-eared slider's day is just getting a good basking spot. Sometimes it's super easy, sometimes no one makes room for the nice lady. And sometimes you just gotta make room. That was great. Alright, Daisy, go to Koaw's next batch of footage. Oh, look, a garden snake.
No, you say garter snake with a T.
Oh, garter with a T. I've been saying that wrong my whole life. So, like, 2 years. Does this snake have really bad gas?
It probably ate a toad.
It ate a toad? Oh, man. Either way, that just doesn't look comfortable. The eastern garter snake is fairly common around here. I see them all the time. This species has a light stripe running along the backside, an almost checkerboard-like pattern along the side, and a yellowish belly. This one looks like it woke up on the wrong side of the bed. Whoa! Koaw did not make a friend on that day. This species does look a lot like the eastern ribbon snake, but the easiest way to tell them apart is just to notice the eastern garter snake has black lines running vertically on the lower side of the head, while the ribbon snake does not. Holy mother of squirrels! Is that snake swimming underwater?
It's a northern water snake.
A northern water snake, cool. I guess Koaw has waterproof cameras, or he is magical. I should probably look at Koa's notes here.
When did you learn how to read?
Oh, I took night classes down at the community center. Did you know you can take yoga classes down there? You should check it out. Anyway, so apparently the northern water snake spends most of its life in and around water. It eats a lot of fishes and frogs. Yep, just like that. Mostly the body is a light shade of brown when dry, but if the scales are wet, the thick, darker bands are more easily seen on the upper body, and there may be some reddish coloration too. This snake, though technically venomous, is not a threat to you humans. Although it's always best to avoid picking up anything with fangs that can bite you. That does hurt a bit. I mean, anything with a mouth can bite you. Look at Daisy's mother. She's ferocious. She bit me on the bum just last week.
That's because you sat on her.
Ah, right. Well, she is tiny. Ah, so there's our next species. A 5-line skink just lounging on some rocks next to a water snake. Brave little fella. The common 5-line skink is a lizard. Skinks are lizards, not skunks. Skink, skunk, not lizard. Wait, no, I'm confused. The adults and juveniles are different colors. The juveniles are super cool looking because they are dark with bright blue tails and those 5 yellowish streaks on the back. The juveniles use these colorful, wiggling tails to hypnotize larger creatures to do their bidding, just like wizards.
No.
Are you sure? I swear I stared at a skink's tail for like an hour, and then I felt like the skink was my wizard master.
That's because you're an idiot.
Daisy, I thought we talked about not calling me an idiot from the last video.
The truth hurts sometimes.
Whatever. Okay, here in Koaw's notes, it says that one purpose for the juvenile's bright tail is to distract a predator. So instead of attacking the skink's head, the predator, like a big old bird, will attack the tail, and the skink can lose the tail escape, and the tail will regenerate. Holy moly, regeneration. Like that, that tail has grown back. That is pretty amazing.
Yes, it is.
The adult five-line skink is more coppery in color, and the males have a very red head, especially in the breeding season. This male with the reddish head is trying to seduce the female. She just doesn't seem like she's very interested. Better luck next time. And I will note that the five-line skink looks a lot like the broadhead skink around here, and I'll have Daisy throw down some links down below to help you better differentiate those two. Ooh, here we have the biggest freshwater turtle around these parts, the snapping turtle. For some reason, Koaw really likes picking them up. But have you ever smelled a snapping turtle? I mean, I've been told I smell bad. Daisy, you practically tell me that I smell bad every day.
You do smell bad.
But oh my goodness, snapping turtles smell like they've been bathing in sewer pipes. Now, you probably shouldn't pick them up as Koaw does. Snapping turtles do have very strong, sharp jaws, and they are heavier and stronger than they might look. A lot of times you'll just see a big old head sticking out of the water. That head is just much thicker and bigger than any of the other freshwater turtles around here. Or if you stick your head in the water, you'll just see them lounging around, doing pretty much nothing, except wondering, why is there a human looking at me? The hatchlings and very little ones like this one don't usually bite, but anything bigger, probably best not to pick up. Snapping turtles have really long, sawtooth tails. Even the little ones have long tails compared to the body length. Well, Daisy, I think we should make more of these. Koaw hasn't fired us yet, so that's good. So subscribe and like, human people, if you want to see more. Koaw has footage of like 100 different animals around here, and I'm really, really good at this narration job.
You're terrible.
Terrible? No way. Try terribly awesome. Spread some knowledge. Be nature heroic.
Bye, human people.